In today's video, we will take a look at a very common administrative process that is performed very often when managing a WVD environment. And that is the process of updating the session hosts when there are changes that need to be made to applications, operating systems, or other system components, and doing so in an automated, scalable way across the entire virtual desktop environment. Because Nerdio Manager for WVD leverages desktop images, either one or more images that can control the state of multiple session hosts, this is the place where we'll begin. So let's take a look at desktop images. This is the screen where you will see all of your currently defined images. You can manage them all from this screen. If you power on a single image, and in this case, I have my executive image powered on, you can then RDP or connect to this environment, to this machine, in any way that that you can, whether with RDP, Bastion, or any other remote control tool, and make the necessary changes to this VM. Now, in Nerdio, the desktop image concept consists of two Azure objects. One is a virtual machine that's used to manage the image, and the other is the actual image that is used to deploy session hosts. So when you power on a desktop image in Nerdio, you're simply powering on a particular VM, you're going to RDP into it and make the changes, and then you'll come back to the screen and click the power off and set as image button. And all you do is you click OK, and this sets off a very extensive automation that is going to take this VM that we just made changes to, it's going to clone it, it will sysprep generalize it, capture it as an image, and then update the image that's associated with this VM and change the date stamp on the last updated column here. So if you can, you can see such a task was run earlier today, I'm going to click on details, and you can take a look at the process that it actually went through. So it went through many, many different steps to basically take those changes we made to the VM and commit them to an image object. Now that the image is updated, we can use it to either create new session hosts, or in most cases, we're actually going to be using this to re-image existing session hosts. So let's take a look at that process. Let's go ahead and click on the production tenant and find a host pool that we want to re-image. And to re-image a host pool is really straightforward. We're going to click on the actions menu next to one of the host pools. In this case, we're gonna select the one called single user desktops. And we're gonna go to the resize re-image option. This is where we can apply changes to all of the session hosts in bulk in the environment. So one of the options here is to change the desktop image, which is exactly what we want to do. So we are going to take our newly updated clean image. We're gonna select it from the list. We could also change the VM size and OS disk, but that's not something we're interested in right now. And let's imagine I have 100 hosts in this host pool, and I don't wanna be updating all of them at the same time, but I also don't wanna do them one at a time because that's just gonna take forever. It's gonna take a very long time. So I'm gonna update 25 hosts at the same time. Now, if I were to just click OK on this screen, this would trigger this process right away and spawn 25 concurrent tasks of updating all of my hosts inside of this session of this host pool to the new image. But I don't really want to do that during business hours because I don't want to disrupt my users right now. I do want to do this overnight. So I'm going to enable the schedule and I'm going to select a time frame of 1 a.m. to 5 a.m., which is 4 hours central time, and click OK. Once I do that, this task is going to go to sleep until 1 a.m. and then it's going to begin re-imaging the re-imaging process 25 VMs at a time until it's done. And then either it completes before the end of its time frame, which is 5 a.m. in our case, or if it's not done by 5 a.m., it's going to go back to sleep and then resume its process the following night until the process is done. So really with just a few clicks, powering on the image, making changes, powering it off and sending it as image in the Nerdio Manager, and then re-imaging a host pool, we're able to take any necessary changes and apply them at scale to any number of session hosts and do so non-disruptively outside of business hours.